There. All right. New York Congressman Tom Suozzi is a Democrat on the House Ways and Means Committee. As you're keeping an eye on this, I mean, what do you think about this move by the Trump administration?
You know, this administration has talked about how they have this great plan for the future. The Republicans in Congress have talked about this great plan for the future, and they've never actually told us what it is. They just want to repeal and not really replace. And people have spoken very clearly. They want to keep protections for pre-existing conditions. They want to keep kids that are 26 years of age or younger on their parents' plans. This has just been very irresponsible on their part. We had a hearing not long ago at Ways and Means about pre-existing conditions, and the Republicans said, you know, we get it. We finally get it. Stop bringing this up all the time. We want to keep pre-existing conditions. And now they're talking about repealing Obamacare again. It doesn't make any sense.
Let's talk about the Green New Deal, of which you're a supporter. Republican Senator Mike Lee, as a lot of Republicans, is not. Here is his plan to end climate change.
The solution to so many of our problems, at all times and in all places, is to fall in love, get married, and have some kids. American babies in particular are likely going to be wealthier, better educated, and more conservation-minded than children raised in still industrializing countries. This is the real solution to climate change. Babies.
Everyone loves cute babies, but this debate is becoming a parody. Republicans are arguing that is because of what was proposed by Democrats. Do you want to see a more realistic plan out there coming from your party than this Green New Deal? Or do you think that this pie in the sky approach, this wish list, was important to getting the conversation going here?
Let me first say that I know Mike Lee. He's a wonderful guy, and he probably really believes what he's saying, but I don't think that's the solution to the problem of climate change in the world. And there is a real problem, but we all know it. I mean, let's talk in real life, practical terms. We're all worried about the floods. We're worried about the cyclones and the hurricanes and the forest fires and the sea level rise. I mean, it's real. This is all real stuff. The droughts. We have to recognize that there's something dramatic where our Earth cannot respond as it historically has to all this human impact that's happening. It just can't take it anymore. So we need Democrats and Republicans to actually work together to solve this problem. Now, the Green New Deal is a very, very ambitious, over-the-top idea to try and solve this problem, but you really need something to shock people out of their torpor to say we have to do something different than what we've been doing. And while some of the ideas are you know, seem extraordinary, almost a fantasy land, we need to have that type of aggressive ambition to really address something that's been ignored for much too long. I mean, I remember this issue being talked about in the late 80s, early 90s. So we've got to finally wake up and face the fact that our air, our land, our water, it's all impacted, and we have to do something about it once and for all.
There's a pretty stunning statistic out today. The head of Customs and Border Protection said that the immigration system is at its breaking point. They're seeing the highest number of migrants in years, over 4,000 in a single day, 100,000 this month. These kind of numbers haven't been seen since 2008. What is responsible for this uptick?
I think a lot of it has to do with the problems that exist in El Salvador and Honduras and Guatemala, where people are just fleeing this awful life conditions there with gangs and poverty and violence, as well as all the press that this issue has received by this administration and by the debate that's going on in our country. And the bottom line is everybody's got to stop with all the hyper rhetoric, and we need Democrats and Republicans to actually work together to find common ground to address a very real problem. We've got over 11 million people in this country that are here undocumented, some for 30 years, 20 years. I know lots of kids from my hometown, went to school with my kids, and they've now graduated, they're in college, they got a master's. I was with a kid last week, has a master's degree in biomedical engineering. He's getting a doctorate in biomedical engineering, but he came here on TPS from El Salvador when he was 5 years old, and now they're talking about deporting him. So let's look at the human beings involved, and let's secure the borders, and let's work together and solve the problem.
You do have an immigration bill that you're going to be out with it soon, as I understand the timing of this, with Republican Congressman Peter King, who is your Long Island neighbor. And the goal is a bipartisan approach, which I think many people who are looking for a solution to this say that's admirable. I wonder, though, about this part where Dreamers and others who you just mentioned, those with TPS, temporary protected status, can apply for protection from deportation for $2,000. Because as you know, the current fee for DACA is $495, and only about a third of the 2 million Dreamers who are eligible applied under the Obama administration. And the number one reason that they didn't, according to one study, was because it was too expensive. You're quadrupling the application price, putting a lot of that money toward a wall under an administration that canceled DACA protections. Why is that going to draw applicants?
Okay, so we're talking about 5 million people, 1.9 million Dreamers, 400,000 TPS recipients, and 2.7 million of their relatives and sponsors and other folks like that. 5 million people times $2,000 a piece is $10 billion. With $10 billion, we're going to put $4.3 billion.
Only if they can afford it.
Only if they can afford it. And we're talking about having scholarship programs available for people.
There's already scholarships, and you had the number one reason for the people not paying a quarter of what you're proposing for $495 versus $2,000, saying it was too expensive. They could not afford it.
I've talked to so many DACA recipients and so many TPS recipients who say they're spending thousands of dollars on legal fees to try and get them protection, tens of thousands of dollars even in some cases. And I've talked to so many people that if they could have the peace of mind to have a path to citizenship in this country, if you're a DACA recipient or TPS, that they'd be happy to pay $2,000. And we need to recognize the fact that we have to find a way to find compromise in this country to protect these human beings while at the same time securing our border, working together to find a common ground solution.
I hear you're talking to people who are telling you that, but the numbers are showing that they can't afford it.
Well, I have to look at the report that you're referring to specifically, but most of the people that I know that are DACA recipients or TPS recipients are going to work 6 days a week and they're going to church on Sunday. And they're hardworking people trying to make a better life for themselves and their families. And many of them didn't come here yesterday. They've been here for a decade or 20 years or even 30 years in America trying to live a better life.
All right, sir. We will talk to you again soon. Congressman Suozzi, thank you for being with us.